We're now heading away from the dam overlook area. If you recall, we came out from back that way, and now we'll be stepping around the gate and start working our way out of the park. If you look, they have some information about COVID. Maybe this will be in the history book someday. If you look up here, we have the park office. Looks like there's actually some folks up there today. We're heading out the inner gate. Looks like there's some different like sports craft over there for the core. We'll see where our journey takes
out
us
of
today.
Mahoning Lake area and down the road.
Long ways to go. Nice red barn. Nice scenery, looking the other direction, looking back towards the lake.
On a different note, sometimes we put our fingers up and do jazzy hands.
Jazzy hands.
Because, like, the blood goes all the way down.
Mm-hmm. Here, let's do it. Jazzy hands. Came to a camp area, really nice. Little piece of paradise for some folks. Little villa here, really nice. Water's flowing in all directions. Behind us, you can see the creek. Got Abby moving up Creek Road. If you look over to the left, you can see a bridge coming to an intersection. Background, very pretty. Here we are coming out Creek Road. Baker Trail sign cuts up to the right. There's a bridge to the left. We'll break off the trail just a little bit. Let's take a look. Lower Mudlick. Very pretty. Looks back to where we came from. Should watch the road. Don't want to get run over. And there it is in the other direction. Coming up on a little family sets of houses. Big rig over there, really nice big rig. Coming up the hill, looking over to our right, sign from Mahoning Dam, 2 miles, Government Road. Came back from that direction. Here we are coming to a nice creek and bridge. Looks like there's a remnant of an older bridge out the upstream of the bridge. We're on Eddyville Road. See what we have on the other side here. Trail goes up that direction. Don't drop the camera. And we have some more creek action down this way. Trail came from this direction. Going up a hill here, some nice farms. Behind us with a nice barn, really nice. We're on Eddyville Road. Field out on Eddyville Road, really nice. Trail heads this direction. Take a look around, lots of farmland on Eddyville Road. Very pretty, met a nice lady who offered some water. Coming to the village of McWilliams. I'm assuming whoever it was, the last name was McWilliams. Maybe it was first. Doubt it. Anyhow, came from that direction, heading in this direction. The lower McWilliams Bridge, Armstrong County. Nice creek. Trail will head up to the right up there on Fisher Road. Right here it says Brahms Hollow, or maybe Brahms Hollow. I'm probably pronouncing it wrong. Trail goes up this way. Looks like a pretty big hill. Natural gas station here. It says Fisher Station. And the trail keeps going down this way. It goes up this way somewhere. I see the marker. View of a farmscape over this way in the distance. You can hear a guy on a tractor. Out to a field here. Looks like the trail slips around to the left. Here's some metal being collected for recycling. There's actually a mark on the rock as the trail heads off that direction. This is the trail. Pretty high grass through this area. Right before I had the camera going, a big buck came out. Way in the distance, you can see a farmer back there doing something to the field. Looks like mowing. View out over the hillside. Big farmer field. The view and the trail. We got to a clearing here. Not sure what the pond is for. You look that way, lots of grass. Here we are coming out of this trailhead. Intersection of 839, we'll be going down that way. Back in civilization. Here we are heading down the hill, Baker's Trail. Coming up to a bridge here, nice little creek. Don't fall, Abby. It says, upon this rock construction, 1989. On this sign, it says, Upper Pine Run Bridge, County of Armstrong. It actually identifies Robertson Pinsky, Carl Culp, and Donald Toy as the commissioners. The top of the hill, and if you turn around and look the other direction, check this out, the view. You can see way in the distance. If you look straight ahead, right there, you can actually see the smoke coming up from the power plant, or steam. But we were actually there several days ago. It's kind of neat seeing all this.
Now it looks like it used to be a school right here. It says 1901 to 1942, near Cemetery in Mount Tabor Cemetery. And pots up for sale. So.
Intersection of Minnick Hollow Road. Schreckengross Road. See? The birds are singing, it's beautiful.
Awesome.
Absolutely. Big tower up there. Looking back. Beautiful scenery. Not a cloud in the sky. Birds are singing. Very, very pretty. We are coming up on the intersection of Dry Ridge Road and Pierce Road. Trail veers off here to the right. Goes up this way. Here's where we came from. Wave, Abby. View of the trail as it heads towards new freedom. Beautiful farmland here. Here's the ending of Pierce Road. Beautiful farmland in here.
Right now we're near Trinity Cemetery of North Freedom. And it's pretty nice.
We are arriving at the North Freedom Methodist Church. This will be where the end of the hike is.
Or today.
That direction, the church. Easy little jaunt, huh? And we're going this direction on Sandy Hill Road. I wonder what kind of adventure we'll have today, huh? Look at the little things that Abby found on the trail.
Can we get ducks?
We have ducks. They look like mallards or some variant of mallards. you have geese, you have ducks, you have chickens. Turning. Putting out a Ringgold. That's my finger. Watching the PennDOT workers working. Fixing the road. You can see the change. Coming up on the Langville shelter. Very nice in here. Can't see it yet. It's kind of dark with the shadows. Nice little trail into the place. I can totally envision camping here. I can see camping here. This isn't bad.
There's a big spider.
Spiders never hurt anybody. A little fire pit. The shelter itself is actually very nice.
Switch backpacks. He got Big Bertha, or Backpack Joe.
Here we are looking up the road. The gentleman here has a lot of old tractors. Start coming up Sandy Hill Road. Big hill. See the trail marker? If you look behind, you can see Abby walking up the hill. She's being the
pack slave.
What is it? Pack backpack gel? Don't worry, Dad's only gonna make you do that most of the time. Some pictures of the Amish landscape. Very beautiful farm. Trail goes down that way. If you look back this way, it's a Amish person, family. Zion Road. I was just looking back and I caught this view of this great lake. Also, my daughter is going on strike. Very beautiful land. We are looking back on the farm we just passed coming up this hill. Beautiful drive. Patton Road, I'm sorry, and a cemetery. Patton Road goes down a long ways down that way. We came up this way. And heading this way, I'll get some more shots of the cemetery. Little small cemetery. And the road goes down this way. Looks like a nice stretch of road. Coming to a change in the trail. It's going off the road and going down the hill here. Nice sign. It says Baker. And the trail goes on down, way down the hill. Very nice place in the trail. Very, very nice. No hunting, you know, posted, though it is marked for Baker's Trail. Pretty grassy. Behind us was like a pine tunnel. Coming out of the trail, we're heading towards the Red Bank Trail. Check out this view. And trail goes down that way. And we came from up this way. Again, check out this great view of the valley. They're not on the trail, it's just right off, when you get off the trail, is a bridge for the Red Bank Trail. Nice scenery. Came from up in that direction. If I'm reading the map right. Came down from this direction, heading on the trail in this direction. I'm gonna get a little segment of the Red Bank Trail. This is really, really nice in here. You can't take a picture of anything in particular, but it's just like a green explosion with all the hemlocks and all the different trees that are creek on the one side of us. Just a beautiful experience overall. Nice part of the trail. coming out to the end of the Red Bank Trail. Get it up. Coming out into civilization. Red Bank Trail is really nice. Back this way. I have to go biking onto here before too much longer. Coming out of the Red Bank Trail. The Baker Trail seems to go up here and across the bridge. Here's a view of the Red Creek. Very pretty trail. I'll be heading up that way, over by that trailer. Nice views of Red Creek. Look at it on the other side. Trail came from that direction and goes down the hill. Let's see if I can just get a through this high grass and up this way. Old trailer there. Trail keeps heading up the hill this direction. Not too bad. Last place we've seen for a while. Here we are. I think we're lost a little bit, but hopefully we'll find the trail again up here. Beautiful scenery. Road. Trail comes back from this direction. Came upon a unique site along the trail. Somebody must really like railroads. Lots of old insulators and such. Little cemetery up here on the road, side of the road. All the names seem like they're Smith. I wonder if they're all related.
Intersection.
We're heading that direction. The trail cuts down here to the right. All these vast fields, beautiful land. You can see the mountains in the distance over that direction. The hay.
Take a cold shower.
Saw this weird painting on the rock. I'm still trying to figure out what it says completely.
There's a blaze on it.
Trees on top of it. Trail keeps going down this way. Coming to an intersection here, Johns Hill Road, going down that way. Up here is I'm not sure if this is part of Johnsville Road or. Nice view down over the hillside. Trees obscure most of it. You can see Red Creek down there, coming up to a really nice looking farm area. Beautiful barn. Thought I'd do a loop back and show this beautiful, beautiful field and area as we head towards Summersville. Here we are coming to the outskirts of Summersville. We'll be going across on the Toadtown Road.
Hey, do you want to stop it?
We are. We're walking out of Summersville and heading up on Toadtown Road. Looks like we're going to be going out into the country from here. I think the next up after here is Corsica. We're now walking towards the Summersville shelter. It was a little bit through the woods. Nice little hike up a hill. Looks like it's been cleaned up. The TLC from the 2018 book. Looks like it was done. Summersville shelter. Got here's the fire. Here we are coming to Duck Road, Black, and connecting up onto Swineford Road. Not sure what the name of this road is. I'll have to research it out. But the trail keeps going up in this direction on Swineford Road. Looking into Union Township. Looks like there's a lake and farm in the distance. We are leaving Clover Township. Trail's going forward. It is becoming a real scorcher today. View of a nice farm. Nice lake over there. Trail goes up that way. Hill. And if you look over to the side here, get an amazing view out into the distance. Behind us is the road, the hill and stuff. Plowed field. Very amazed at the view. And we're on our way to Corsica. Here we are coming up to the intersection of Douglas and Swineford. Trail veers off to the right up here. Straight is Windy Lane. And here's where we came from.
Right now we're in Corsica downtown. It's really cool. Now we're near, we just saw this sign that says Clarion ahead and Dubois. To the side, and then I think there's a bridge ahead, and then right over there there was a post office we passed. Crossing the bridge, there's a lot of highway, tons of trucks, it's really scary, but see you on the flip side.
Look up, Abby. Here's Abby and I. I can't see us. It's like too dark. Here, come over here. Here's Abby and I. We are finishing up for the day. We are at I-80. Moving right along. On the Baker's Trail. Not a Corsica in the rear view mirror. So we'll talk to you later.